Welcome to the episode 2 of the clock project. Previously we created a clock in PowerPoint, and create its animations, using Visual Basic Script. In this episode, we will use that clock in a Power BI dashboard, and display current time on it. So, without further delay, let's start our today's tutorial. Open the SQL Server Management Studio, and connect it to the SQL Server. Create a new database for your clock project. Enter an appropriate name for your database, and press OK. Currently your database should be empty, without any tables. Now, create a table in the database. Create a column to store serial numbers. Create another column to store time. This will be a string, not the time data type. Create a column to store the URL of clock images. Select a variable large enough to store image paths. Now, save the table, with appropriate name. Here is our table, with the columns we defined. These are the images of clocks, that we generated using PowerPoint and VBS. We will copy these to a web server. We are using XAMPP server, so we will place this folder in the htdocs folder. If you are working locally on Power BI desktop, you do not need a remote web server. You can use localhost. It is far better in performance as well. Our files have now been copied. Now, we can start the server, and view the files, in the web browser. We have deleted the default files from XAMPP server htdocs folder, therefore we are now viewing our images folder only. You can click on one of these images, to view them in the browser. Their URL will appear in the address bar above. Now we will use SQL query, to supply the image from this directory, that represents current time, to Power BI. In SQL query, we will create a loop, that never ends, and each iteration has a break of 1 second. First, we will declare a variable, to store current time, in the same format, we used to name our image files. Now we will provide the current time, to our variable. We will use the concat function, to combine hour, minute, and second. Remember, this should be in exactly same format, as you used to save the image files. We saved images using hour, minute, and second, separated by dashes. We will do the same here. Then, we will declare another variable, to store file names. File names are same as time, combine with .png. Finally, we will create a variable, to store the complete path of the image. Complete path includes the address to the HTTP directory, where images are placed, and the file name. Before inserting data into the table, we will delete the previous entry. Now we will insert data, using insert command. Serial number is not needed, therefore we will just enter 0. Then we will enter the time, and the path. Let's test our code now, by running the query. The query is running, without any error or warning. Let's view the data, using the select command. And here is the last entry. Remember, the table only keeps the last entry, and before inserting the data, it deletes the previous one. Now let's connect this table to Power BI and run the query. In Power BI Desktop, first we will insert an image visual and select an appropriate background for our animated clock. We will place the background image appropriately. Then, we will use the Get Data button to connect to the SQL Server. We can get the server name and database name from SQL Server Management Studio. Enter the name of server and database, and select Direct Query to update data per second. Click on the OK button, and connect to the server using appropriate credentials. In the Navigator window, select the table you want to connect to, and click on the Load button. Now you have all the fields available for visualizations. Now we need a custom visual named Image Viewer. We will import it from a file. After importing the visual, we will place it on an appropriate location. In the URL field of the Image Viewer visual, we will place the clock field. Now we should see the image of the clock, because we have one URL entry in our table. We will place it appropriately. And turn off the title on the Image Viewer visual. Now turn on the page refresh, and set the update interval to 1 second. Now go to the SQL Server Management Studio, and run the query. Let's go back to the Power BI desktop, and see the results. Great! Our clock is working beautifully. This concludes our tutorial. Application of these tricks and techniques is up to your imagination. Thanks for watching. We hope you liked our tutorial. Don't forget to like, subscribe, and hit the bell icon for more insightful tutorials and updates.